Hello everyone, it's Nicolas from Autokroma. Today I will introduce you the new BRAW Studio source settings, released from BRAW Studio version 2 in our panel. The aim of these new source settings is to improve the BRAW Studio experience in Premiere Pro. So first, after BRAW Studio has been installed or updated, you can open it by going to Window, Extension, BRAW Studio Panel. By clicking at the top of the panel, you can drag it and place it wherever you want. On this video, I will focus on the source setting tab of the panel. Please check the video description for more information about the other tabs. So let's begin by the selection. If you select some BRAW files in your timeline or in the project panel, the source settings panel will be automatically updated with this selection. So here you can see that the RAW parameters are changed, but also at the top, the project item name, and some metadata about your BRAW selection. With this way of doing, no more need to go to the effect control panel and then click on the master tabs to access to your BRAW parameters. Now everything is in the BRAW Studio source settings panel. Also, you will see that the same nice features from the BRAW Studio source settings are there, like the custom AB or the 20 global presets. You can, if you want, fix the selection of the panel. After that, any click on the timeline or in the project panel will not update the source settings panel anymore. If you want to get back to the normal, click on unfix selection. Also, note that the source settings are linked to the source and not to the clip. So, for example, here, I have two clips coming from the same project item. If I change the exposure of one and make it dark, the other will be also affected. In order to have two different colors, I need to duplicate the project item. We are currently working on a feature to cut a clip in two parts, which will come from two different project items, and so the original project item will be duplicated. That will solve this problem. With the source settings panel, if you select multiple clips in your timeline or in the project panel, you will enter in the multiple clip selected mode. For example, here I selected 8 BRAW clips. In this mode, for example, I can apply one preset to all the clips in one click, and same for all these features here. It can be really useful, for example, if I have one clip, I select the RAW parameters, I click on Save in my presets, and if I know that all the other clips should have the same color grading, I select all and click on Load. And all will have the same RAW parameters. Note that the BRAW presets are the same for each app, so they will be the same in Premiere Pro and in After Effects. As they are stored locally in a folder in your computer, it is really easy to transfer them to other computers. Please check the video description to see an article which explains how to do that. In the source settings panels, the Prev and Next buttons are a new way to quickly go through all your clips in your timeline. When you click on one of these two buttons, the cursor in the timeline is updated to the start of the clip. So it becomes really easy to grade your BRAW files one by one. For any action made in the source settings panel, in one clip or also in multiple clips, you can undo this action by clicking on this button or redo the action as well with this button. Note that there is no shortcut for this undo action because Premiere Pro already has it. So just few advices and information now. If you have any issue with the panel, you should see a red alert at the bottom right of Premiere Pro. Also, the panel could not respond. In that case, please hit the reload button. Also, if I change a parameter in the source settings panel, for example gamma here, there will be no indication at the top window that the project has been modified. So just remember to save your project anyway. Compared to the free Blackmagic plugin, this panel is not the only benefit of using BRAW Studio. Our plugin is now as fast as the Blackmagic plugin, and sometimes is faster. You have the 20 global presets, custom A-B comparison, the BRAW metadata in the project panel. There are less bugs, you can export a working XML for Resolve. It supports After Effects with the layer settings effects. Well, there is a lot to say, so please check the video description for a detailed article comparing the two solutions. So, this is the end of this video. For more details in articles, once again, please check the description. We hope you will like this new source settings panel and that it will improve your daily workflow. Some new features are about to come soon, so stay tuned. And if you have ideas how to improve this panel, please tell us.